one album and you're just some good old boys from your hometown and you're putting the album out yourself and you're independent, there's only so far that you can reach with that. And then you get another set of tools added to you when the label comes in. You get to make another album. And then that album has enough intensity that carries you to a place to where people are like, I know who these guys are. I recognize these people. There's a brand here. I see it. I feel it. I can touch it, so I know it exists. And I think that once we get this next album out, you'll see that we've been allowed, like, not just a tool belt, we have a tool truck. You know what I mean? We're not worried about building the doghouse now. We're not worried about building the garage now. Now we're building the mansion.
That's one of the things that we've really done a really good job on, is being able to get this thing to have a, you know, wider appeal. And keeping it very, it's very heavy, and it's very sort of, you know, organically heavy, but it's also, you know, we've got some good songs in there too.
When I first started this band, there was an appetite for this attitude and this swagger and the brand that THC is. And then as everything started taking off, I started realizing, hey, there's a hunger for this. Let's give them what they're hungry for. But now, in making this album, the people are starving for it. And there's fixing to be a feeding frenzy, because all sharks are born with teeth. And we're fixing to feed everybody some good old Texas barbecue. We're Texas born, we're American made. You know, we're Red Dirt Originals. We are the band of outlaws. Everybody else can go out and be whoever they want to be, but nobody else is going to be the band of outlaws.